Hello friends, welcome back to Awelstech. This video is in relation to my another video on no boot, where Windows fails to boot with error 0x7bc34. As that video was without audio and contained mostly only images, I found that most of the users were unable to follow the steps as they were not clear. That is why I have decided to recreate this video. So, when Windows OS fails to detect the controller driver or any other boot critical drivers, it fails to boot with stop code 0x0000007B, and in the bracket you would see 0x and the last two digits would be 34. The second parameter of the code here is important. 0x34 means system is unable to load controller drivers. The drivers could be either corrupt, missing, or altered by some third-party applications. Since the controller driver required to detect bootable device could not be loaded, the stop code 0x7b means inaccessible boot device. Let's see the steps to check your registry for any third-party drivers that could be causing this issue. Step 1. Whenever you get this error, first try running check disk. The reason behind this is, running check disk repairs the block where the controller driver is located on the disk and thus makes it available for the system to load it again. If running check disk doesn't help, then try the step 2. First, boot the OS into Windows recovery environment using Windows 7 and above bootable media. The bootable media could be any client or server Windows post from Windows Vista or Windows Server 2008. It can be either Windows Server 2008, Windows 7 Client, Windows 8 Client, Windows 2012 R2, etc. Okay, so once you insert the bootable media, press any key to start the system using CD or DVD. On the next screen, select Next without changing any options. On the Install Now screen, click on Repair Your Computer. Okay, on this screen, check if your correct OS is listed and also note down the location of the disk where the OS is installed. In this case, it is D drive. After you click Next, you see System Recovery options. On this screen, click on Command Prompt to load the command prompt in the memory. If you see, the command prompt source is X drive. Remember, X drive here is your RAM. Since the recovery environment is loaded from RAM using the bootable media. Now, type regedit and hit enter to open the registry. Okay, so the registry that you see here is not the actual registry of your server. Instead, this registry is loaded from the bootable media with default options. So, we need to load the system hive of our server. To do this, click on HKEY local machine and then click on load hive. Please note, if you do not select any key under computer, you will not get the option to load hive. This is because the hives are loaded under the keys displayed under computer on the left hand side of your registry. Go to file, select load hive, click on the computer icon. Now, if you remember earlier, you made a note of the location where your OS is installed, right? In this case, it was D drive. So click on the drive where OS is installed and then navigate to Windows System 32 config. Under config, you see all your registry hives, SAM, security, software, and system. As we need to check if there's any third party driver causing the 0x7b error, we will select system hive. Please note, system hive stores all the drivers and boot related information. Since this is the hive that is loaded first during the boot process for drivers to initialize. Click on system and hit open and give any random name to this hive. Let's give the name test and click OK. Now, expand the HKEY local machine and select test. Expand test and click on the select hive. Under the select, check value against default. In my case, it is 1. So select control set 001. A small note, the drivers and the application to load is stored under the control set. So the default control set will be loaded every time. In case if you know your default control set is corrupt, you can load the backup control set. In this case, I have a control set 002. So simply change the number of default from 1 to 2 and then reboot the system. However, let's not do that here. I have a separate video that explains the steps in details. Now, expand control set 001, then expand control and then expand class. I will maximize it and pull it so that I can see it clearly. Now, expand the class as well, right? So the critical system drivers that I'm talking about are the default filter drivers. If any third-party driver interferes with them, in that case, the OS fails to boot and gives us such weird errors. So most of the time, it is your antivirus that is found here. Let's see where to find them. These filter drivers are located under the keys that start from 4D36E965 to 4D36E980. So now, one by one, check all these filter drivers and check for values in front of upper filters. You may not know the default values, so compare these values with your working machine to understand if they are as expected or if they have been tampered. So there are like CD-ROM, computer, disk drives, display drivers, floppy driver controller, ATA controller, keyboards, etc. Now, in the keyboard under the upper filter along with the KBD class, I have additional entry as STY and TYP. This is not expected, as when I check it against another working server, there was only KBD class. Okay, so now the solution. The solution is simple. Double click on the upper filter, clear the additional entries. Okay, once that is done, you can continue to check following keys until 4D36E980. If you do not find any extra entries, then click on the test hive again and select unload hive from file option. Close the registry and command prompt to reboot the server. Let the server boot and see the result. If this doesn't help, then proceed with the registry swap. See my another video on how to swap the registry. That will help you. Alright friends, I hope you find this video helpful. If yes, please hit like and do subscribe. Have a great day ahead. Goodbye.